Okay, here we have an example of a pie chart. We're going to talk just a little bit about some interpretation issues that we have when we're looking at pie charts. In this particular pie chart here, I've got an example of a class that was being surveyed to find out where they wanted to go on a field trip. So in this case, we have all of the results of the class are displayed here, and they're just broken up into different parts and portions. So anytime that you have a whole and you know about all of the parts, we can use a pie chart, because a pie chart requires all 100% of the data to be represented in the actual visual that we see. And this works great in this particular case. All right, in this question, or in this problem, let's go ahead and see some of the things that they might ask you to do. In this case, the question is asking us how many students want to go to the History Museum for their field trip. Well, let's look at what the pie chart tells us. Look around for the History Museum, it's right here, and we see this value right here, and we know that 30% of the students would like to go to the History Museum, so we can put that in here. However, this is really actually not what the question's actually asking us to find. Let's take a look up here. If it wanted to know what percentage, the question is going to ask what percentage. In this case, we have a slight variation here. The question asks us how many students want to go to the History Museum for their field trip. We do not have enough information to answer this question right now. All we know is that 30% of them want to go, but we have no idea, without actually knowing how many students there are in the class, we have no idea about how to get this information. So we need the total number of students to be given for us to be able to figure out a number from a pie chart. If instead we were told that there were 30 students in this class, now we would have enough information to actually be able to figure this out. We know that 30% of them want to go to the History Museum, so 30% of the 30 students want to go to the museum. Now it's just a matter of remembering a few of our percentage things. Anytime that we have a percentage given in a problem, we always need to convert it to a decimal form before we do any calculations. For 30%, to change a percent to a decimal, we move the decimal location, which right now is at the end of the problem, we move it two places to the left. So we can write 30% as 0.30 or just 0.3. The keyword of is a good clue for multiplication. So to figure this out, we want to find 30% or 0.3 of, so times, and then we just fill our 30 in. Do 0.3 times 30 on your calculator, and we end up with a total of 9 students in the class that would actually be interested in going to the History Museum. So again, pay attention to what your question's asking. If it asks you for a percentage, we can find that information straight from our pie chart. If it asks us something about how many, then we're actually going to need to know a number. And because our pie chart only gives us percentages, we would need to know the total to be able to take that next step and actually come up with the solution that we're looking for.